second important change has to do with how we look at the broad-based criteria which needs to be fulfilled if a certain FPI needs to seek registration under Category 2. Now, it's defined as a fund incorporated outside India which has at least 20 investors with no investor holding more than 49% of the shares or units of the fund. The committee has suggested that broad-basing shouldn't be just determined only through shares but should also extend to any economic form. Richie, what has prompted this suggestion and how will this change things for FPIs?
Right. See, I think as far as the broad-based criteria is concerned, I think there are a couple of significant changes. The more significant change we saw was SEBI also for the first time through the committee recommendations keen to move a position that if we are relying on a fund to meet the 20 investor requirement, then that underlying fund should itself also be broad-based. And over and above, it should hold at least a minimum of 25% economic interest in the FPI. Earlier, there was a situation which the committee report sort of illustrates that you could have two investors at 49% each and another broad-based fund being in the mix at about 2%, which still makes the entire platform a broad-based vehicle. To plug that, the recommendation seems to be that such fund should at least hold 25%. Now, which is where I think the feedback which the industry could convey to SEBI or to the working group in this regard could be that under the current laws itself, SEBI mandates that if an FPI is relying on another fund or another shareholder which is a broad-based entity, then it should meet all the other eligibility criteria prescribed by SEBI to be an eligible FPI. So in that case, should a 25% test be applied, should the test at all be applied, if the test should be applied, then would 25% be the right threshold? Can we consider a 10 or a 15? There could be a lot of reasoned basis for which the industry could ask for the test not to be applied or a lower threshold. So there clearly is a lot of scope for industry feedback for the committee to take.
Okay, so that to pick up from the earlier point that Richie made, the example that the committee has used is that let's say to achieve the broad-based criteria, there are probably existing structures which say there is one shareholder at 49, there's another shareholder at 49, and then there is a fund which has come in at 2%, and then this fund perhaps may have 20 investors. And because of this 2% fund is how you are achieving this broad-based criteria,
correct,
which the committee is suggesting is not really in the spirit of the regulations,
exactly,
right? How will these, changing the structure of some of these existing funds in the market play out now, and what do you see as the impact of this?
No, so I think, yes, you rightly pointed out that was the concern raised from a regulatory side, that the idea of offering a broad-based status should also in spirit show that there has to be a reasonable economic interest of such a broad-based investor for the entity to qualify for broad-based. And having said that, I also feel, and I think I'm sure a lot of feedback that we are also getting from the industry, this will be an area where you see a significant amount of pushback. Because fund structures, whether that 25% threshold is something which is too high for a lot of fund structures to kind of comply with, to meet the broad base, failing which they will all get essentially classified as Cat 3. Or whether maybe a reasonable threshold, and I think we might, and I'm sure industry will give feedback to the work group on
any,
this.
Do you know the thought process behind this 25% threshold?
Actually, I mean, there's no science the way I look at it.
Understood.
I think the idea was that there should be a meaningful interest, and it cannot be a nominal interest. So 2% was seen as nominal.
And are then there too many of these 2% kind of structures in the market?
Well, I think people may have in the past used it.
Okay.
And that is exactly where the concern for the regulator was, that it is not meeting the spirit of why that flexibility was offered. But I guess whether that 25% should be 25 or should it be 10, I think that's something that the industry will feedback. I would think anything upward of 10 starts showing a material. So even just to kind of draw a parallel, a portfolio investment to strategic investment now under FEMA is 10 is a threshold. Yeah. So maybe that could be a threshold which can be used.